Speak Broccoli!
Hello and welcome to this Speak Broccoli tutorial. I've gotten a few requests for this one, so today I'm going to be showing you how to make a YouTube thumbnail. Now I'm basing this tutorial on my Lego Spider-Man Bad Timing video. I'm going to be using a free website called canva.com for editing my photos. In my early videos, such as these two here, I would often just use one of the three photos that YouTube randomly picked for me. You can see this when I uploaded my Spider-Man video. The three on the right are randomly picked, whereas the one on the left I uploaded myself. Now there is absolutely nothing wrong with using one of the three that they pick for you. Sometimes you end up with quite a good still image, but going forward I think it's better to get into the habit of taking your own. So step one is focus, and by that I mean who is the focus of your movie. I have chosen Spider-Man, although in this movie, Captain Marvel has just as much, if not more, screen time than Spidey. So how do you choose? For me, Spider-Man plays the bigger part because he interrupts the moment. However, I could have easily used a photo of both Captain Marvel and Spider-Man. Deciding on the focus is the hardest part. Keep in mind the focus doesn't have to be a person. Maybe you've created a really cool set and want to show that off. The key is to create a striking image that will hook your viewers. Something that they simply have to click on. Step two is the photo. I thought it might be helpful to cycle through some of the photos that didn't make the cut. On a typical YouTube thumbnail project, I can take anywhere between 20 to 100 photos. There really are no hard or fast rules at this stage. My advice would be to take as many different photos as you can. Try altering camera position, both high and low and near and far. Experiment turning off some lights. I had three lights in this film, so I alternated turning them off one by one. Don't be afraid to move your lights around. Place your character in different poses. You won't know what works until you've tried it. Remember, above all else, to be honest. Do not try bait viewers in with something that's not in your movie. When you've taken all the photos that you can, I generally try to cycle through them all and pick my three favorites. This is not an easy task. However, my advice, once you have the three, would be to walk away or sleep on it. In the morning, with fresh eyes, you'll know which one to choose. Now the third and final stage, enhance. No matter how good the photo is, it can always be improved. So for this, I'm going to take you to the free-to-use website, www.canva.com. All you'll need to sign up is an email address. So this is the homepage. Go to the Create a Design button in the top left corner. What I love about this site is that it already has pre-made templates for literally every social media platform. However, the quickest way is to go to the search bar and type thumbnail, then choose YouTube thumbnail. This is your editing screen. Normally I rename the project first by typing here, then choose uploads on the left-hand menu. Click upload an image and find the photo on your computer. The photo may take a moment to upload, but you can click on it and start to edit in the meantime. First thing I do is resize it to cover the whole white canvas by dragging the photo out from the corners. Then you can reposition using the purple guidelines to find the dead center. Before I make any edits, I'm going to duplicate this photo because I like to constantly compare what I'm editing to the original. The filter tab up top isn't something that I use a lot, but it does give you an easy click solution if you see one that you like. Simply click and the filter will be applied. However, I'm going to reset this by clicking none and navigate to the adjust tab. So generally I always boost the brightness a little by dragging to the right. Don't worry if it looks a little washed out, because we're going to boost the contrast a little to balance it. A lot of my process involves adjusting these two settings till I find a look I'm happy with. I'm going to skip the other settings for the moment and go straight to the blur option. Now if you drag it to the right, it's going to blur your photo. Not what you want. However, drag it to the left and it will sharpen the image. Again, moderation here is key. Too much in it will distort your image, so don't drag it too far to the left. Now compare your new photo with the original by scrolling between them. Can you see the difference? The new image is much brighter. It pops. The original now seems quite dark. I'm also going to try to boost the saturation a little bit to add color. You can type a value into the box rather than dragging the cursor if you find that easier. And there you have it. Although we only made minor tweaks, you can really see the difference between the new photo and the original. So, navigate to the top right corner, click download. Here you can choose the file type and even which specific pages you want to download. Your thumbnail is now ready for YouTube. If you did want to add some titles to your photo, you can navigate to the text button on the left side. Here you can choose from a variety of different styles. When you find the one you want, Click on it and it's added to your photo. The default color is black, but you can highlight the text. Go to A and change the color. Click on the text you don't want and hit return or delete key. You can also choose a different font at any stage. Then it's up to you what to name it. Take your time deciding on placement, size, and color. So that about wraps up the enhance stage. When it comes to uploading to YouTube, you will get the option displayed as an empty box beside the three randomly picked ones, or you can also change it at any stage by clicking on the three dots. If there's anything I haven't covered or something you would like to see in more detail, please let me know in the comments section below. Thanks again for watching this Speak Broccoli tutorial. Speak Broccoli!